and there he goes. The L39 became the world's first turbofan-powered jet trainer. It was a successor to Aero Vodokany's L29 Delphin as a basic and advanced jet trainer and as a light attack aircraft.
Yep.
More than 2,260 examples of the L39C model, like we see here, were built, and it was the standard basic trainer variant, supplied in huge numbers to the Soviet Union and its allied states during the Cold War, but more recently several countries have upgraded them for continued service. There were armed versions too, used for training and on light attack duties, and indeed they've seen action in those roles in the recent civil wars in Libya and Syria. Libyans also flew their L-39s in their war of the 1980s with Chad, and Azerbaijan used the Albatros for strike missions in the war in Nagorno-Karabakh. But here, running in for its first pass.
No, I have problems in getting around the flying.
L-39s in service with the Estonian Air Force, the first of them delivered in 2011. The air arm had been established as an independent entity 20 years earlier and has been looking to expand its capabilities. It had three Antonov and two transports and four Robinson R-44 helicopters before the decision was taken to get the L-39. Estonia carried out a public procurement for the lease of two L-39s from a Latvian company called KS Avia. That organisation also operates a civilian aerobatic team called the Baltic Bees, and the colour scheme on this aircraft is used by the jets of the Baltic Bees. The Air Force uses the L-39 for training pilots, fighter controllers and tactical air controllers. So this high visibility livery, rather useful for some of those purposes. KS Avia performs the maintenance on the aeroplanes, and the initial type rating training program was followed by tactical training, which made the L-39s and their pilots ready for operations. They're part of the Estonian Air Force's fixed-wing squadron, part of their composite wing, stationed at Amari, a former Soviet Navy Sukhoi Su-24 fighter base. And Amari has seen in recent times many multinational exercises, including deployments by the US Air Force. Last June, or in June 2013, there took place Exercise Sabre Strike, which saw approximately 2,000 personnel from 14 countries deploying to the base. It was designed to improve NATO interoperability and strengthen relationships between US, Estonian, and other participating forces. And some US Air Force pilots flew in the Estonian L-39s during that exercise. Thank you. Baltic air policing mission, whereby NATO provides air defence to the three Baltic states, Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania, has of course assumed a great deal of importance in the last few months, particularly due to tensions regarding Ukraine. And this has seen US Air Force personnel from RAF Lakenheath in Suffolk visiting Omari in April of this year to test the base's suitability as an alternative station for the Baltic Air Policing Mission as the to appear in large numbers on the civilian scene as surplus airframes are sold off by their former military operators. And one can readily understand why. It's a fairly cheap aircraft to buy and operate. Spares are abundant. It's pretty easy to convert onto the L-39, and there's a large community of owners to provide advice. Now a chance to see the L-39's upper surfaces on this high-edge cast. Several civilian display teams operate L-39s. Indeed, we'll be seeing one aircraft from the Breitling jet team in action later, and the full team over the weekend. There are several companies around the world that offer rides in L-39s, and at the Reno Air Races in Nevada, there's a jet class which is dominated by this particular type. Further developed from the earlier L-39C model that we have here, and most radically into the L-159, the Advanced Light Combat Aircraft in service these days with the Czech Air Force. The L-39C we see here, powered by a single Ivchenko AI-25TL turbofan of some 3,800 pounds of thrust. Complete there, Lieutenant Colonel Arvo Palumai from the fixed wing squadron of the Estonian Air Force. The Red 10 squadron leader Mike Ling joining us in the commentary box now reminds us that the Red Arrows were themselves at this aircraft's base at Omari a couple of weeks ago when the Reds displayed. Colonel Arvo Palumai coming into land with the Aero L-39C Albatros.
And Eagle 1 is clear to display.
But now we turn to the Army Air Corps and George.
Yes, back to my home territory at Middle Wallop down in Hampshire there, where, of course, interestingly enough, Tim Prince spent many years in the 80s and early 90s with the International Air Tattoo team running many international air shows at the largest grass airfield in Europe, and a lot of fun we had indeed, cementing good relationships between the International Air Tattoo and the Army Air Corps at the time. But keep your eyes to the right-hand side now, because running in is the same aircraft you saw being in here just a little bit earlier, the Mark 70, and very much the mainstay of Army Air Corps operations for many years, particularly through the 80s and 90s, and the 80s synonymous with the Cold War and the British Army of the World.